epic weekend. We're here at dinner waiting for our food. We are at the Claw House. There's my friends right there. There's our waitress. Got a cool bar over there. There's the water. I think it's the inlet. That's right. Wicked tuna over there. It's a marina. About to eat some seafood. Merle's Inlet. Seafood capital of the world.
We can go faster.
But it was nice, like, being able to take our time with nobody behind us on the back today. That was nice.
Can I put my point in?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. Sorry. So, my only point is, yes, me, Justin, and I do take longer on the greens, but maybe you guys should do it too because we're beating you guys. More often maybe y'all need to take longer on the green.
Since the handicaps have started, it's pretty square.
Okay. Just put it out there.
Damn.
Good point.
That was just salacious for the audience. <Yeah. laughs>
I wasn't expecting that.
I didn't see that coming either.
That's beach throwing.
Damn.
I'll just say that we're about to go to the grounds and let them fucking play through. Beware of
it. Something's about to go down.
Right when the guy was honking his horn, I was like, ah, shit. Dan's about to put this one in the hole.
I was telling Dan, he needs to be really careful tonight. Because last time he played Caledonia, that's when he hurt himself.
Yeah, oh, I know. Oh, shit.
Yeah.
No PGA Superstore tonight.
No swinging with no clubs, nothing.
No.
You need to be real careful tonight. He almost ran over a biker on the way here. It's like,
well, I mean, it wasn't really even my fault. Like,
no, it wasn't your fault.
He signaled and then went the
That would have been the end of Caledonia.
Well, you did try to arm curl your whole bag today, try to get it over the bridge.
Oh, yeah, that was going to be where I would injure myself. I moved a piece of furniture yesterday, and I didn't injure myself.
But that's right. We almost beat y'all, and he was hurt at Caledonia.
I don't know. I think being hurt made him swing better.
I didn't swing anything. But that was the wider base.
It kept your base steady.
Right
here.
You know what, Dan? I thought it was interesting that you spent.
All right, guys, I finally won.
You spent four rows doing this.
From everybody.
Well, he built the damn settlement.
We already had the longest road.
Well, I didn't want the road. I just wanted the settlement.
Injury,
yeah, but you could
at
just
the Catan board.
Yeah. And got a settlement.
Dan almost broke his wrist.
Well, no, he was already over there. Like, he was already over there.
By the time you did that, Alan didn't have any of this stuff.
I guess I couldn't
make
it. You
could have
got one road and a settlement.
Yeah, I guess if I would have gone the other way, the game would have ended. But I didn't.
It's not my fault.
I blame you. It's not my fault. It is your fault. It is all your fault.
Note the difference in the wash of the shirts.
Notice the
for
difference.
Future.
Yeah, you didn't wash your shirt properly, and it's your fault.
Somebody's shirt's not washed.
Somebody used the harsh detergent.
Oh, man.
I don't understand. Like, we'll go on a road trip, and I'll ask her, like, hey, babe, you want to eat something in the house before we go?
The Chick-fil-A?
And she'll be like, no. And then
because it's coming up soon.
Well, we'll leave the house. She's like, will you pull in such and such and let me get something to eat? And I was like, no, we can stop there and eat. And she's like, but that'll take time. And I was like, she's like, why can't I eat there? It was just that one time. And I was like, yeah, one time's going to turn into two. Like, we will stop and you take all the time you want to eat here.
I done told you. We do not eat in this car.
Exactly.
Dan will never hear the end of it.
I'm glad you're putting your foot down.
If you tell her that happened while she's pregnant, I'll kill one of you. I'm not going to deal with that, really.
But I heard your friends were eating in the car.
No, it'll be more like, Daniel, you let your husband eat in your car and not your wife? That'll be the race.
Yeah, because he treats me better. We have nightcaps.
He doesn't spill lettuce all over and make me clean it up. Yeah. He's a good eater.
I'm serious, man. It looked like there's a goddamn salad of bony lettuce under that. Yeah.
Look, there's one person at Arby's.
Yeah, maybe we should have done Arby's.
Arby's is terrible.
What was that?
I like Arby's.
You like Arby's?
Yeah, the classic roast beef sandwich.
Roast beef is actually like roast beef and
cheddar. That's a damn good. Okay, with the horseradish sauce?
Horseradish sauce.
What is wrong with you?
Oh my god. So actually, it's really good.
If you guys like Arby's so much, why are we in line at Chick-fil-A?
Chick-fil-A is awesome. Because they got ruled out. We said Arby's, Subway, and Chick-fil-A, and we got down to Subway.
I thought it'd be more efficient. They kind of let me down on the efficiency.
They don't have people outside.
If this was Leland Chick-fil-A, we would all have eaten and be putt-putting right now.
Yeah, that's true. Arby's.
That's true.
We're so impatient. Why are we so impatient? We've been here like 10 minutes.
Oh, man, I remember Arby's. They came out with this Jamocha shake. It was like the first time they made this flavored milkshakes. They were the first ones.
My dad loves Arby's.
High school,
too.
I was like, we gotta get a fucking Jamocha shake after class.
You know what'll blow your mind about Arby's?
What?
What's the initials for roast beef?
RB?
RB.
Fuck.
Roast beefs. Arby's.
It just blew my mind. Yeah, you're an Arby's family.
Yeah, my dad loves Arby's.
Dad loves it. Son loves it.
I mean, I'm not. I don't love it.
I don't love it. I like roast beef.
Do you love Chick-fil-A?
Yeah. I think I might love Chick-fil-A.
Yeah.
Do you love your butter? Are you in love with it?
I love your butter.
Are you in love with your butter, Carl?
Me? Yes. I thought you were talking to Justin.
No.
Oh no.
You just bought one.
Yeah, I'm in love.
And the whole thing about with Dan said, do you love it? Are you in love with it?
He said he liked it.
I love my butter. I love it. I'm in love.
We're past her honeymoon.
I like
phase.
Just looking at her, thinking about her, like touching her.
Yeah,
solid.
Metal. I've been looking at other putter women. I noticed they came out with the same Sigma I have in like an all black finish, which I know won't hold up as well, but looks good.
A putter will.
Now I've noticed the nicks on my face, and they'd be much more noticeable on a. One that was like that black matte finish versus.
Yeah,
I think it looks good whenever a club gets old.
Can I just send you one collective Venmo when we leave South Carolina?
I don't do Venmo. Never.
Venmo
and pottery. No way.
Venmo and pottery.
Absolutely no pottery.
Did we stay with. Oh, that's right.
Absolutely
no pottery.
I'm so serious.
Absolutely
what
not.
What was he thinking about?
That's awesome.
There's a story.
Yeah. Absolutely
your grandma was
not.
Like, Potter, absolutely no Potter.
Yeah.
He was staring out the window.
Yeah. Didn't even turn his head.
Drinking a coffee.
Who's this?
A friend of the family.
Yeah. We went to the U.S. Open when it was at Pinehurst, and he was staying with her because he was like a volunteer for it. And he was asking what to do in the area. And my grandma, because there's like a lot of pottery places that you can go look at. She said, oh, you should go look at all the pottery places. They're really neat. There's absolutely no pottery.
And your grandma was smart enough not to follow.
She didn't even question it. Just dropped it.
Just drop it.
She didn't say, why? Why not?
I know.
You would like it. Yeah. Most people would do that. Oh, you'll like it. She knew. Could, from that conviction. Absolutely
your
not.
Grandma has lived.
Yeah. You guys have a card?
I can just give you.
Pace of play, fellas.
Do I need to do anything?
Closest to the pin. Number 2, Gilligan's Island Funhouse. Closest to the pin. Justin going under the rock, peeking around. Oh! Oh! It's an ace! Somebody. What a shot.
They don't even know.
Jesus.
Daniel's terrified.
Shit himself. He shit his britches.
He was terrified. Oh. Like,
ah. Oh.
What?
Oh my god.
That was like the plank.
I didn't get that. That was crazy. Oh, here.
went out, hit here, and came back.
It was like the plank hole.
It's like
number nine.
Yeah, this is where it's going up. We're sticking.
Is this the other way? That's the wrong way. We just came from there.
It's a short one.
Okay. I will never leave my apartment! Let's go!
Welcome, viewers at home, to the final day of the Epic Championship at Pawleys Island. Series is tied this weekend at one win, one loss, and one tie. Everybody's experienced the highs and the lows that come with this game of golf. That's pretty good. No recognition.
Okay, we're just waiting on your next statement, Carl. We don't feel very engaged. It's just the summer.
I need a color commentator, somebody to like keep it going.
We're all riding the residual wave. You might not get a lot of any of
us. <wave. laughs> So basically what I'm saying, this match is important. It determines who wins and has bragging rights.
I'm just going to say, while you got the camera out, get a video of this albino squirrel on my right.
Oh, shit.
Maybe he's not an albino, but man, that's rice. Excuse me. I'm just kidding.
Nature.
Cited a tradition. I see you on our kitchen table this November, man. Look at that. It's going on.
Just experienced the first pinata hole, pinata pin. Pinata this guy pin, been looking for candy.
Yeah, I did not appreciate two lips on the same hole. So I
second
hole
lip was real big lip.
I don't want to sit here.
What is this?
Yeah, sit up there.
We can go to tee box now.
That was the sixth hole here on the front of the tradition. Two lip shots, and I let it.
You're hitting it better now.
A little bit of frustration out of it.
Yeah, let it go.
It feels good.
Let it go.
It feels good.
You're hitting it good now.
I clearly did not hold in my anchor, so now I'm.
You guys still got a point?
Yeah, I got 8 points. Waste of a good stroke.
It's all right, we're up by one.
Really?
Yeah.
Holy shit, we should be up by two.
Well, let it go. Mitz putts happen.
Yeah,
we that'll be your
par four, and
that'll be your one for the match.
Continue to strike the ball. I haven't had any disturbing putts that I've missed this weekend, so I guess I was.
Yeah.
I really didn't have a good.
You gave us
it,
a show.
So
you
I
gave
tried
us a
to
good
hit
show.
A little bit hard, but.
Another show that was missed. Mr. Chippin from the sand. I missed so many Dan moments. I missed your putt for par at Caledonia that held onto the lip.
Yeah, but we don't have to document everything. They're in our minds. That was.
I just want to say it so it'll trigger the memory.
Thank you. Oh, we're just out here with friends celebrating our.
What?
You guys retook the lead.
Big hole.
By 1 point. Mm-hmm. One Stableford point. Stable. How do you say it?
Stableford.
Now we're on the hardest hole on the course.
We tend to throw the
go ahead.
E into the stable.
367 yard par 4. This is a hell of a time. My heart's beating.
What do you have to say? Well, think about the tradition.
It's pretty cool. It's nothing special yet, but we're just
compared to the level that we played the last three rounds.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is kind
this
of a step down.
Not in the same tier,
but it's still amazing.
Yeah.
It's good.
It's good. It's a good course.
It's a good course.
Yeah.
It's a good course.
Gonna make that. And get points. So my golf friends. Don't mess it. Think I'm a good golfer.
You got like a
something.
5
else.
Over 10.
I'll take a square. I feel like I'm not playing very well.
All square.
I started off well. Jeez. Thunder.
Thunder, man.
onward.
Want to eat the rest? The peel protects it from all the sand that's flying around. You don't have plastic or any trash to throw away afterwards. Like okay. Beef jerky, you have to throw away the bag.
So your point, my point, is that for at least a week, somebody's going to see trash on the beach.
It's a banana peel.
Yeah, it's trash. Like, oh, people don't know how to clean up after them. That's what they're going to feel.
Shells, though?
Those are so small. You don't notice them.
People going to step on it. They're going to hurt you.
They don't hurt.
Dan cut his foot yesterday.
On a pistachio shell?
Maybe.
No, it's called concrete.
At the miniature golf?
I don't know how.
It was concrete that I'd forgotten was there, but it wasn't because of pistachio shells, Justin.
But somebody could step on. You ever step on a pistachio shell with your bare foot?
Never.
I would rather step on that than glass.
Pistachio shells would not hurt. It's rounded edges all the way around.
What?
Not and it would sink it to the sand.
Yeah. You've lost this.
Yeah,
argument.
You ever step on
it? Give it up.
What if I went into your
what if you stepped on
house and just threw banana peel on your yard?
Ooh. My dog would eat it and he'd be like, "Thank you."
Dog would choke on it.
Yeah, banana peel is as big as Oliver.
Those things like dry you out. Like you ever tried to eat it? Like
banana peel? What?
You tried to eat a banana peel? That was weird.
See, I told you people eat it.
I didn't eat it. I tried to.
Banana peels.
Animals eat banana peels.
Maybe pigs. That's about it. Pigs eat anything. But, you can't physically eat it. Like it's non-digestible.
What made you think that you wanted to eat the peel? Did your parents tell you you couldn't as a child and you just had to try?
You're like, nah.
Bear.
So let's think about this.
Those are threes and twelves.
You ever step on a shell? You ever step on a shell?
Like a real shell?
Like a shell.
Like from the ocean?
Yeah, it's a shell, right?
It's the name of it is yes, shell.
And does it hurt when you step on that?
No. There's billions of shells on the beach. You can't miss them.
How do you get out of the water?
Step on them and they don't hurt.
You walk over shells.
Doesn't that hurt?
Billions of shells on the beach.
It was a pistachio. It's a pistachio shell.
You just add
the seashell. It's a nutshell.
Yeah. What's going to be softer to step on, a pistachio shell or a banana peel?
Justin, banana peel is gross.
The next time we go to the beach, I'm getting a big old bag of pistachios and I'm eating them like right next to you. Just so you know.
I'm going to eat a banana peel next to you and we'll see who's the better person.
Okay.
I think orange is going to be a good beach snack.
You want to come back in a week?
An orange? Spot.
Orange.
All that citrus, you get your hands all sticky.
What's the last time you ate an orange? You gotta have something that has nothing to throw away.
But you can peel the orange and just pop the, like a tangerine. Just,
yeah, but what happens to your hand? They're completely sticky.
No, a tangerine, you just peel the thing off. A tangerine?
What?
Yeah, those things are easy to peel.
You still get the orange juice on your hands.
There's not that much juice in it.
You can't have something to throw away at the beach. It's annoying.
Everything's gonna have
unless it's a banana peel. And you just throw it on the ground.
We got time. Let's just hear the group behind us got us.
There's trash cans at the beach.
Yeah, there's trash cans at the beach.
You don't want to walk across the hot sand.
What are you gonna eat that's not in a package?
Oh,
an apple?
Okay. Anything else that has.
Apple has the core. What are you gonna do with the core?
You can eat all of the
stuff on a core
is
gonna hurt more than stepping on a banana peel.
You can eat the core.
You can eat a banana peel. Probably
eat the core.
Carl. Right? Can you eat a banana peel?
You can't. Physically not possible.
Grapes.
You got the stem. Unless you pre-pick them.
Discussion. Grapes are great.
But then you have to carry them in a bag.
But I'm carrying it in a... What do we do with this after the grapes are done?
Put it back in the cooler.
That eliminates it.
Orange.
There's no food that doesn't... The tangerine. It's different.
Nope. They got trash.
It's the same.
I know, but everything has trash.
Nope.
Okay, so I didn't say it's perfect, but what's the best?
Apple.
Banana peel.
Apple, you can eat everything.
Not the peel.
Give me an apple, I'll eat it all, I promise. There's a core is a misconception.
What about the stem?
There's no such thing as an apple core. You're just wasting apple.
Hey, but you'll eat the seed.
So.
Hold your finish. Hold your finish. Oh, what?
The wind. Yeah, sorry. Do you know the best score Justin's ever shot?
89, 87, 88.
He might be on watch.
Holy shit!
Yeah. Big stick.
Not over until somebody's on the ground. When you hear that bell toll, draw.
Is he talking? Get there. Palmer! He willed it over the sand.
Nice shot.
Arnie, that's your miss. Arnie's army. Follow Arnie. Yes!
Here. Running away with this one, Dottie.
I think they're up by double digits.
Just fun to watch.
Cue up the Law and Order reruns.
Oh no.
Oh,
oh Larry, you decelerated.
You hit it like ass.
Butted ass.
You mad?
Well,
I was dying.
Well, gents, 18th hole, fourth round. It was a pleasure spending time with you guys.
Yeah, it was
fun.
It's been some ups and downs.
We got the competitive match out of the way real
went
early.
To hell and to heaven.
Caves.
A lot of prop bets.
But I wouldn't have it any other way.
Against the rolls. You gotta go big on this
one. Money. Everybody gonna hit driver on
$20 to win the hole.
All right.
I want no handicaps.
No handicaps.
Longest drive, drivers only.
Oh.
Sorry, too soon.
I think I want to play $20.
That's it.
For the hole.
You in? Finish strong.
Sure. Well, if you guys are doing it, I'll do it.
Make it interesting.
I'll do it.
We lost the epic, but we can win the money. I'll share the money with you, Dan, if I win.
I can go the distance, I can lay up, I can pick an easy swing. You, 7-iron, deserve to be cleaned. Thank you, 8-iron, I don't use you as often. And I scuffed you up on a rock 2 weeks ago.
Oh, I scuffed him?
Yeah, and I made very bad marks and blemishes in
it. Is that what you birdied with today?
I apologize.
The 8 from 120?
You hit a 9.
No, that was a
pitching wedge?
Pitching wedge.
Damn.
Yeah. I wait till I get to that.
Oh,
pitching
okay.
wedge deserves to be cleaned the most. Thank you, 9-iron. You are my go-to club on most par 3s. Versatile par 3 club. Thank you for getting me on the green. That one approach on that one par 3. Took an easy 9 swing.
Alright. Dan's tired of the gratitude.
Pitching wedge.
Yeah. Pitching wedge is the best.
Pitching wedge is the best. I can do
Clean
anything
it.
With this club.
Anything.
Ooh. I can close my eyes.
Just feel
and
it.
And still go.
Use the force.
So the pitching wedge is better than the gap wedge? Man, he blows off. Oh, it's the scraper.
Oh, the special scraper.
Pitching wedge gets special attention.
Pitching wedge. You can chip with it. Or I can chip with it.
I can chip with it.
I don't, but I could.
You can chip with it. Or I can.
It got me 120 yards. Pretty much a gimme birdie today. It can get me anything from 80 yards to 125. This is my club. I salivate at my mouth whenever I'm in
Damn.
Range for this club.
Salivate.
Now, you may think, because of all the accolades and praise for my pitching wedge, that it's my favorite club. It's not.
Oh, curveball.
This club, it's got an A on it.
The Allen. A club, the Allen club.
<It's right. laughs> My partner, my teammate, best team ever, but that's not what GTZ stands for. And also is my approach wedge. And that's exactly what it does. It does everything else. This club does everything else.
Yeah.
It equals all the rest of my clubs combined.
Ooh.
This is my favorite club.
Put that in the cart.
Yeah. Sand wedge, nah, fuck this club.
Dang.
I don't really like it. Hardly ever use it. The only time I use it is when I'm upset. Because
really?
I'm in the sand. The
sand. Yeah.
This club can just... Thank you for the club, Dan, but this club could just eat shit.
That's why I gave it away. I didn't like
yeah,
the club
fuck
either.
This club.
Maybe you need a new sandwich.
Keep it in the bag because... Yeah. Dan gave it to me, and I appreciate that.
You could throw it.
Otherwise, fuck that club.
That was years ago.
Fuck that club. I don't need anything. I don't need any club.
Mufasa, you know we finally here, right?
Well, we...
It's Friday then, it's Saturday, Sunday. It's live again. It's live again. It's live again. It's live again.
Be over this by now. Yeah, it's been too long since we got crazy. I'm lucky spinning out. I'm counting down till Friday come. I'm gonna do too much. No, I'm all in my bag, that's clutch. Feeling it, feeling it, feeling it. Every Friday, Saturday, Sunday, endless weekend on a wave, yeah.
All right, everyone, Epic Group, first video of the weekend. This is our home for the weekend. We are on right at True Blues, hole 17 green, I think. We already have some action here. Let's see the type of competition in the field today. Looks like Ryan Lochmere hit it short of the green. He's looking to chip, maybe putt. Oh, he's putting. He's got a mallet putter he just bought at the golf discount store yesterday. They're playing Ready Golf. Oh, look over here. We have Joey. Joey Lochmere, the brother, didn't quite get as good. Looks like he's got a little chip. Is he good at putt too? They are brothers. Oh, nope, he's gonna do a little chip. Let's see how he fares. A tough one. 17 is a pretty tough hole. Looks like it's a, I don't know if it's a par 4 or 5, but it's pretty. Let's see how he does. Boom, hit it squarely. And, oh, he is wet. Oh, he sees me. He was looking to see if the crowd was watching him hit that in the water.